جنوده ورسلهم.
بعد
فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Welcome sisters, in the last class about the book of manner. Sorry, let me fix this. This is the last class of the book of manners. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding in religion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the reward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us on the sirat al-mustaqim. But يعني, inshallah, this will not be the last class with you, but it is the last class about the book of manners. Inshallah, inshallah, in the future, we'll have other classes. Bidnillah ta'ala. طيب, let's continue the chapter of dua. The chapter of dua. This is very important. Chapter. We finished point number 11. So now point number 12. Point number 12. استحباب تقديم الحمد والثناء على الله ثم الصلاة على رسوله قبل الدعاء. This is very important, sisters. The introduction. It is recommended to preface one's supplications with praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then the sending of prayers upon His messenger. You are requesting something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, so we should be polite and we should praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before requesting Him. So this is the sunnah from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he mentioned hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here the Imam supplicate in his prayer. We are on page 482. 482. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here the man supplicate in his prayer without glorifying Allah and without sending prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said to him, أجلت أيها المصلي, you have rushed, O worshipper, or the one who is praying. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here the man prayed. The man glorified Allah, praised him, and sent prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, اُدْعُ تُجَبْ وَسَلْ تُعْطَى. اُدْعُ تُجَبْ وَسَلْ تُعْطَى. Supplicate, you will be answered. Ask, you will be given. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the second one, now it is the time you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, while the Prophet ﷺ was seated, a man entered and prayed. He said, Oh Allah, forgive me and have mercy on me. The Prophet ﷺ said, you have rushed your supplication, O worshipper. When you pray and then sit, praise Allah with praises He is deserving of and send prayers upon me. Then invoke Him. So this is one of the manners of the dua, sisters, that you invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after sending, after glorifying Allah, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very important. This is very important. Yani, you are going to ask, subhanallah, when we ask your boss, okay, usually we give some introduction. Then we ask for a loan, for a help, or whatever. So asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who deserves all the praises, all praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you should start with that. Okay, is it wajib? Is it wajib? No, it is not wajib. Why? Because we can notice in some ahadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said dua, he made dua without introduction. If you remember, we mentioned the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to his mother, for Abu Huraira and his mother. He said, Allahumma hadi Abi Huraira. Okay, so the Prophet went to the dua directly without saying Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam Rasulillah. Okay, so it is not compulsory, it is not wajib, but this is one of the etiquettes of the dua. Okay, before asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you say, Ya Allah, Ya Dhul Jalal wal Ikram, Ya Wasi' al Maghfirah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, Allahumma laka alhamd, Anta Nur al-Samawat wal-Ard, Wa ma baynahun, Wa ma fihin. Okay, you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, Wa ala ali Muhammad, Kama sallayta ala Ibrahim. This is, no doubt, highly recommended. But if you make the dua directly, we will not say this is haram. will not say this is haram. Number 13, asking for one's supplications to be answered by dint of previously performed good deeds. As we mentioned, if you remember the hadith, the three people who went to the into the cave, and everyone asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by a good deed, tawassul. Okay, this is also one of the etiquettes of dua, to make your dua stronger. Oh Allah, I gave this charity and you know that I was very sincere and I was in need of this money and I gave this money to my friends or to the people, the needy people. Okay, so you give this introduction before your dua. This is also one of the etiquettes of dua, التوسل. This is called the tawassul. Number 14, istihbab jawami' al-du'a. It is recommended to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with supplications whose meanings are comprehensive of all that is good. طيب, يعني, if you read the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will find many hadith includes many things. I mean, sometimes no need to go in details, but we need the general dua like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يعني for example in Surah Al-Baqarah, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Our Lord give us in this world that which is good and in the hereafter that which is good, and save us from the torment of the fire. Okay, this is one of the general dua from the Quran. رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنَ. Our Lord bestow on us from our wives and our offspring who will be the comfort of our eyes. So sometimes you don't need to mention something specific. Make it general. Oh Allah, make my grant my children to make me happy. The things to make me happy and also to please you. Okay, not only to be an A student, not only to be an A student, not to only to memorize Quran, everything and anything to make me happy, and of course, which is halal. طيب, and also one of the main hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِ عَلَى دِينِكَ. Or the one who turns hearts over, straighten my heart upon your religion. طيب, this is of course one of the main hadith, main dua. Also about the maghfirah. اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر ذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لي مغفرة من عندك وارحمني إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. Say, oh Allah, I indeed wronged myself with a great deal of wrong, and none forgives sins except for you. So forgive me with a forgiveness from you and have mercy on me. Indeed, you are oft forgiving, most merciful. طيب, so subhanAllah, this is a very nice dua, a general dua. We need to say this dua. So sisters, try to choose the dua which is general, not to go in details every single point. Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used, not of course always, used to say the dua which has the general meanings, which is called Jawami' al-Kalim. Okay, it includes many things. Number 15. Istihbab, it is recommended to end one's supplication with that which corresponds to what he asked for. My dua about the maghfirah, the forgiveness. So use the name Al-Ghafur, Al-Ghaffar. My dua about repentance, At-Tawbah. So use the name At-Tawwab. Your dua about you want your wife to be pregnant. Okay, you like to have a children, to have a child. Then you use the name, for example, Al-Wahhab, the bestower. Okay, this is important how, I forgot to start the Instagram. So you need to understand the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to understand your dua. Okay, how can you use the corresponding names? You need to understand your dua and the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very important. This is very important. Okay, sorry, brothers and sisters, I forgot to start the Instagram, but you can watch it inshallah bin Allah, and the live for Ulum Academy, live YouTube, and also my live YouTube. For example, what he mentioned, the ayah, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ وَهَبْ لَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. Our Lord, let not our hearts deviate from the truth after you have guided us, and grant us mercy from you. You are the bestower, and grant us هَبْ لَنَا الْوَهَّابُ. Okay, you got the point, sisters, that you mentioned the verb هَبْ لَنَا and the name, sorry, الْوَهَّابُ. And the name is الْوَهَّابُ. يعني for example قال عيسى بن مريم اللهم ربنا أنزل علينا مائدة من السماء تكون لنا عيدا لأولين وآخرين وآية منك وارزقنا وأنت خير الرازقين. عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, Jesus said, okay, in his dua, and provide a sustenance, for you are the best of sustainers. طيب, so this is important. Okay, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the name الرزاق or الرازق, وانت خير الرازقين. So it is important to have a relationship between your dua, okay, between what you are asking and also the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, you need to know the meaning of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also you need to know the meaning of your dua. طيب, also one of the points that الدعاء بعد التشهد الأخير في الصلاة وقبل السلام, supplicating after the last tashahud of prayer and before the taslim, the end of the prayer. طيب, let's say this hadith. Okay, listen carefully, sisters. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, related in a hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam taught the tashahud of the prayer to his companions, then explaining what one should do after that. And before making taslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Thumma yatakhayyar min ad-du'a a'jabahu ilayhi fayad'u." Then one may choose the supplication he likes most and then invoke with it. Muslim related it thus, "Thumma," then he may choose to ask for whatever he wants. Actually, in here the author, okay, I hope that you know the name of the author. His name is Fuad Shalhoub. Okay. So if you notice the author, he said, after the last tashahud. Okay. After the last tashahud. But the hadith did not mention the last tashahud. The hadith mentions the tashahud. So you can make dua even the first tashahud. In the first tashahud. So if you like to make, if you and for example, especially your sisters, you are praying at home alone. Okay, so you are doing the tahiyyat, at-tashahud. So you say the dua, you say at-tahiyyatu lillahi wassalatu wattayyibat in the second rak'ah, and you are praying al-maghrib or al-dhuhr or al-asr or al-isha. Can you make dua? Yes, you can make dua in the first tashahud. You can make dua. Why? Because in this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned Abdullah ibn Mas'ud mentioned the tashahud, and he did not specify it is the first tashahud or second tashahud. The first or the last. This is understanding from the author. It is an understanding from the author. So if you like, you make tashahud. If you have time, you make dua and the first tashahud also. Okay, you make the first tashahud and also the last tashahud or the second tashahud. Can you make dua? Yes, you can make dua. You can make dua in the first tashahud, second tashahud. And yani sisters, take your chance. You are praying at home alone. The problem for us, for men, yani, I mean the fard, because we join the jama'ah, the imam usually doesn't give us the chance. The imam doesn't give us the chance. Yani, we finish the tashahud, ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa la sharika lahu wa ashadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu, allahumma salli ala muhammad. Immediately you'll find the imam stood up for the next rak'ah. Even some of the imam don't give us the chance to continue our tashahud. So if you are praying at home, and also this is for the brothers, if you are praying at home, the sunnah, okay, يعني take your time to make tashahud at the end of the salah. At the end of the salah, I mean, even if you are praying two rak'ah before the salah, make dua. make dua. This is a very good time for dua. Don't wait after the salam. Because I notice now many Muslims, what do they practice? After the salam, Allahumma aghfir li wa li walidi, rabbi arhamhuma kama rabbayani. Okay, why? You are in the salah. You were in the salah. In the salah, this is one of the best places to make dua. So why you miss this time and you delay your dua to after the salam? Okay, so don't delay your dua after the salam. Do your dua where? Inside the salah. When inside the salah, in your sujood, okay, at the end of the tashahud, after the tashahud and before the salam. Okay, can you make dua during the ruku'? Yes, you can make dua. It is allowed. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did dua. He used to say, Subhanaka Allahumma Rabbana wa bihamdik, Allahumma ghafir li. Yes, he used to say in the ruku' Subhan Rabbi al-Azim. He used to say, Subuh Qudus Rabbul Malaikat wal Ruh. And also to say, Subhana Dil Jabaruti wal Malakuti wal Kibriya wal Azam. Okay? Mainly in the ruku' we need to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, Amma ruku' fa'adzimu fihi al-Rabb. Glorify your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where? In the ruku'. And in the sujood you do dua. But know that in the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his ruku', in the ruku' while bowing, he said, Subhanak Allahumma Rabbana wa bihamdik, Allahumma ghafir li. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness. طيب. Number 17, to make dua when you hear the beak. It is recommended to supplicate when a rooster crows. In an authentic hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ida sami'tum siyah ad-diyaka." Ad-diyaka is the plural of diq. Diq is singular. Diyaka is plural. "Ida sami'tum siyah ad-diyaka, fas'alu Allah min fadlihi, fa'innaha ra'at malakan. Wa ida sami'tum nahiq al-himar, fata'awadu billahi min ash-shaytan, fa'innahu ra'a shaytanan." Okay. For every animal, there is a sound. Okay, there is a name for his sound. So for the deek, for the rooster, we say siyah. For the donkey, we say nahiq. For the horse, we say sahil. For the camel, we say atit. Okay, different. This is in the Arabic language, those who are interested to know. Okay, they can check the books, the Arabic books, okay. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you hear the crowing of a rooster, then ask Allah from his favor, for it means that the rooster has just seen an angel. And when you hear the braying of a donkey, then seek refuge in Allah from the shaitan, for it means that the donkey has just seen a devil. Ibn Nawawi rahimahullah said, related to the Al-Qa'idah, gave, Al-Qadi. Al-Qadi Iyad is one of the scholars who explained Sahih Muslim. He is Al-Qadi Iyad, before Al-Nawawi, rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Qadi gave the following explanation for the first part of the hadith. The one supplicates on this occasion and the hope that the angels will say Ameen to one supplication, and that the angels will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his forgiveness. Yani, he's trying to explain what is the point to say, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you hear the roosters, because the angels attended, are present, so they will say Ameen for your dua. This is explanation from Al-Qadi Iyad, rahimahullah ta'ala, Al-Qadi Iyad al-Yahsubi. Number 18, transgression in one supplication is forbidden. Transgression. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ud'u rabbakum tadarru'an wa khufya, innahu la yuhibbu al-mu'tadeen. Invoke your Lord with humility and in secret. We mentioned that. Innahu la yuhibbu al-mu'tadeen. He likes not the aggressors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like the aggressors. This is forbidden. This is forbidden. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said in the hadith, where is the hadith? Yes, verily there will be a people in this nation who will transgress in their purification and supplication. Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned this hadith. Okay, and we like to know who narrates for us this hadith. Abdullah ibn Mughaffal, one of the companions. Abdullah ibn Mughaffal, very nice, brother, sisters, please pay attention. Abdullah ibn Mughaffal heard his son saying, "Oh Allah, for when I enter paradise, I ask you for the white palace, white castle, that is to the right of paradise. Oh Allah, when I enter paradise, I like white palace, okay, on the right side." Then his father heard him. Abdullah ibn Ghaffal is a companion, but his son was not a companion. He said, "My son, ask Allah for paradise and take refuge with him from the hellfire." Then he mentioned this hadith. Said, "Yani, we need for these details. What is, wallah, I like the white palace, the right side, okay, shunu? Why you are asking this?" So Abdullah ibn Ghaffal assumed this way of dua as a transgression. So be direct in your dua and don't try to make it difficult or unneeded details. طيب, make it general, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, another way to say that transgression is not allowed in your dua. يعني, for example, you have a problem with your brother. You have a problem with your sister. Okay? Yeah, and maybe your sister, I mean your friend. Okay? She said a bad word to you. Okay, she said you are this and this. And then you make dua, "Oh Allah, let this sister suffer from cancer and heart attack and coronavirus and AIDS." Astaghfirullah al-Azim. This is haram. Okay, because she said a bad word to you. Then you make dua that she has a car accident and to have a divorce and this. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. No. This is i'tida'. Okay, if you like to make dua, then maybe somebody will say, "Sheikh, it is not allowed to make a dua against the people who are abusing me, it is allowed. But your dua should be fair. Your dua should be fair. Subhanallah, some people, let's say they are dangerous. Okay, sorry, astaghfirullah, I will not say dangerous, but subhanallah, when they make dua, Allah answer their dua. Okay, so be careful when you are making dua, because Allah may answer your dua. Okay, and to destroy the person because of a small problem. So be careful. You like to make dua, follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He used to forgive people, even those who ridicule him alayhi salatu wasalam and beat him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made dua for them. Guide us. Like the people of Ta'if, when he went to Ta'if sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they started to stone him, okay, and his legs were bleeding because of the stones, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam fell down and unconscious, and the Jibreel came and he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, "Oh Muhammad, this is the angel of the mountains. This is the angel of the mountains. If you like, give him the order to crush them. Khalas. He can press them between the two mountains and finish." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "La, no, I'm not asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this angel to help me. I like that they will have a generation to say La ilaha illallah without any shirk." And subhanAllah, as I said, yes, later, subhanAllah, the people of Ta'if were very strong believers, alhamdulillah. Number 19, كراهية السجع في الدعاء. When one is supplicating, it is dislike for him to think up an invocation of rhyming words. I like to to make my words يعني smooth, the same endings. اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض. Okay, what is the need of that kind of دعاء؟ ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Okay, this is the دعاء in the hadith. Sorry, in the ayah, in Surah Al-Baqarah. But you notice some imam, they add, وَأَدْخِلْنَا الْجَنَّةَ مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ يَا عَزِيزُ يَا غَفَّارِ. Okay, what is the need of that way? No, they like, wallahi, the same way. أَلِفْ رَا, أَلِفْ رَا, أَلِفْ رَا, أَلِفْ رَا. Even the, يعني, they are not matching. يعني, I mean, يعني, like this dua, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبَّنَا آتِينَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Protect us from the hellfire. Okay. وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. Okay. Let us enter paradise with the good people. Okay. Then you ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى with يا عزيز يا غفار. Okay. Why you ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى with the name العزيز? The يعني something means the strong. Okay. You are asking paradise. You should use the name the most merciful, the bestower. Okay, but they like to have the same end. They like to have the same end. So we should avoid that. We should avoid this way of the dua. Okay, Ibn Hajar. Maybe some sisters say, but Sheikh, there is some hadith that the Prophet ﷺ, you feel that he has this way of dua, يعني smooth and the same endings. Like he mentioned hadith, اللهم منزل الكتاب سريع الحساب هازم الأحزاب. What Ibn Hajar rahimahullah said, this is important from Al-Hafidh Ibn Hajar, one of the scholars of Hadith. Al-Hafidh Ibn Hajar, Ahmed Ibn Ali Ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani, from an area called Asqalan, there in Egypt, okay, or in Palestine, يعني, this south of Saudi Arabia, okay, near the sea, the Red Sea, north to the Red Sea, it's called Asqalan. Is this 852? Ibn Hajar said, Rahimullah, this ruling is not overruled by what occurred in certain authentic ahadith. For that, the Prophet ﷺ supplication containing rimming occurred unintentionally. For example, speaking about jihad, he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Munzil al-Kitab, Sari' al-Hisab, Hazim al-Ahzab. Okay, so this happened without intention. The Prophet ﷺ did not prepare for this dua at night, 2-3 hours. You know, some of the imam, okay, we notice, yeah, and you can maybe notice them, they come for the Taraweeh, Qiyam al-Layl and Ramadan, okay, especially in the night of 27th. Okay, they recite the dua from a paper. Okay, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِيدًا رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدُ. Then they read the paper, اللهم اللهم اللهم, and they cry, and they like people to cry. This is not the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If this way comes without intention, okay, يعني very easy from you, then say it. طيب, but if you are preparing for that, طيب, intentionally, then you should avoid that. You should avoid that. طيب. Number 20, الدعاء بإثم أو قطيعة رحم. This is also very dangerous. Asking help for sinning or breaking of ties. طيب, breaking ties of relation or being impatient for the answer to one's supplications. These actions prevent one's supplications from being answered. This is important, sisters, which is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا يزال يستجاب للعبد ما لم يدعو بإثم أو قطيعة رحم ما لم يستعجل. A slave will continue to be answered in his supplications as long as he doesn't invoke for a sin or for breaking off ties of the womb, and as long as he doesn't rush. This is very important hadith, sisters. Why? Because many of us say, why I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, invoking Allah, oh Allah, oh Allah. But where is the answer? Okay, for 1 month, 2 months, 3 years, 5 years, there is no answer. Maybe you are doing one of these mistakes. In this hadith, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned three mistakes. Okay, one of them, ما لم يدعو بإثم. Okay, as long as he doesn't invoke for a sin. Okay, maybe you're asking, Allah, make it easy for me to accept me working in this bank. It is a riba bank. Or to work in this restaurant. And this restaurant serves the pork and the wine and the haram things. So you are asking for something haram. It's not allowed. طيب. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not answering your dua, because you are asking for something haram. The second, قطيعة رحم. Okay. The second, or for breaking off ties of the womb. You are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, this brother or this sister or this nephew or this uncle, this auntie. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect your relatives and to guide them if they are not good people, and to grant you patience dealing with them. Okay, this is very important. Okay, this is very, very important. The third one, ما لم يستعجل. The third one, as he doesn't rush. Okay. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh. I'm making dua, but Allah did not answer me. When you started to make dua, I started to make dua 3 hours back. Okay, 3 hours? And you want the answer now? Okay, Allah will not answer your dua. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not answer your dua. Why? Because of your rush. You're in a hurry. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 1 hour, 2 hours, 1 day, 2 days. Okay, you don't know what is the good time for the answer. Or maybe it is not good for you to give you what you are asking for. Oh Allah, make it easy for me to, yani you apply for a job in this company. It is not a good place for you. Because Allah knows that if you work in this company, the first day you are going to fight. Or there will be a trouble. Or this company will lose. Okay, how many companies lost the money when Corona started? Subhanallah. Many, many companies closed. Many business people lost their job and their business. So you don't know. But you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course. No doubt, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what I want. Okay, and I don't know the future. And I don't know if for sure this is good for me. But be patient. And don't say why until now the answer did not come. He mentioned here a very important point, sisters. This is very important. Very important. Very, very, very important. Which is, what is the meaning of answering your dua? What is the meaning of answering the dua? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us the answer. No Muslim invokes with a supplication that doesn't contain sin or that severing of ties with relatives, except that Allah gives him one of three things for it. Okay, so answering the dua doesn't mean necessarily that I will get what I ask Allah exactly. صح. But out of the three, what is the first one? Either he will quicken the answer of his supplication, this is number one. Number two, or he will save it for him in the hereafter, or he will ward off from him an evil that is equal to it. Allahu Akbar. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay, I ask you to make it easy for me to marry this lady. Or I ask you that this brother comes to me. I like this man to be my husband. He's a righteous, Hafiz Quran. He's Imam Masjid scholar, whatever. Whatever you like. Allah, make it easy to buy this car. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the dua. But you are making this dua for 2, 3, 4 months or years. Where is the answer? You don't know. Where is the answer exactly? But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us 1 out of 3. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the answer. You ask Allah something, it happens now, or after 1 day, 2 days, or yani whatever the time. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects you. Allah will not give you what you are asking, but Allah will protect you from an evil. Allah will protect you from a car accident. Allah will protect you from a fire. Allah protects you from a virus. Okay? This is the second thing. Or the third one, everyone, you are making dua. Oh Allah, grant me this. Oh Allah, give me this. You are not getting what you are asking. But what will happen every time? Allah save some hasanat for you, a reward for you, and the akhirah. So this means make a lot of dua. Don't give up. Don't stop the dua. Okay, some people say, Sheikh, khalas, I was making dua for my wife. Now I'm going to stop. I'm not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything for my wife, to any guidance or anything. I said, why? Because there is no use to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For 10 years I'm asking Allah, I did not see the answer. Okay, if you don't see the answer, that doesn't mean this is useless. Because every time you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah reward you. Allah gives you the reward. So don't stop the dua. Don't stop the dua. Keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until your death. Number 21, أكل الحرام مانع من إجابة الدعاء. Okay, this is also very important and very serious. 21, eating from unlawfully derived wealth prevents one's supplications from being answered. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أيها الناس إن الله طيب لا يقبل إلا طيبا وإن الله أمر المؤمنين ما أمر به المرسلين. O people, verily Allah is tayyib, good, pure. And He accepts only that which is tayyib, good and pure. And Allah gave the believers the same command that He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ordered the messengers. Okay, then He mentioned the ayah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya ayyuhar rasul, kul min tayyibat, wa'amalu saliha, inni bima ta'amaluna alim. Then He mentioned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He mentioned the hadith. What is the hadith? This is very important, sisters. This hadith is very important, which is ثم ذكر الرجل يطيل السفر. Okay. أشعث أغبر. So then, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned the man who was on a long journey, whose hair was disheveled. Disheveled, and who was dust covered. The man extended his hands to the sky and said, oh my Lord, but his food was haram, his drink was haram, and his clothing was haram. So then how could his supplications have been answered? Subhanallah. Again, sisters, yani listen to the hadith carefully. There are many things. I mean, this man followed many etiquettes of dua, but Allah did not answer his dua. Allah did not answer his dua. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the man, okay, on a long journey. Okay, so this is one, inshallah, we'll mention this. This is one of the places that the dua will be strong. Okay, and the possibility of your answer to be yani stronger if you are a traveler. So this man is a traveler. Okay, and also a long journey. And also the man extended his hands. Okay, this is also one of the etiquettes of dua. Number two. Number three, he said, oh my Lord. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his names. Al-Rabb, okay? Al-Rabb is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Rabb is one of the great names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he used these three techniques of dua. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not answer him. Why? Because of the unlawful food he's eating. بأنه أكل الحرام وشرب الحرام وغذي بالحرام ولبس الحرام. Okay, He's working at a riba bank. He's stealing the money of people. He is not giving the seller of his maid, okay, or his driver. Subhanallah. So he's earning haram money. So for sure, Allah will not answer his dua. Allah will not answer this dua. So this is serious. This is serious. And we should be careful, sisters. So for those who are complaining, okay, Sheikh, Allah did not answer my dua. You have to check this point. Okay, صح. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is delaying your dua for something good. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not answer your dua because Allah wants to protect you from a car accident. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not answer your dua because Allah will give you reward at the akhirah. But maybe Allah is not answering your dua because your source of earning the money is haram. Haram. Maybe you know, sisters, we should be careful because sometimes we are doing something wrong and haram. But it is not stealing, it is not riba. I will tell you something, and maybe your father passed away or your mother passed away, and you have brothers and sisters, and there is a house. So all the brothers and sisters have the share in this house. Okay, but you are the only one who lives in this house and you want to take the benefit. So you think that you deserve to stay in this house. Okay, because you don't have a house. Hey, this is haram. This is haram. Okay, why? Because after the death of the father, if your father was owning this house, then this house should go for all the children and the wife, if you have a mother. Okay, but to claim, wallahi, all my brothers and sisters have house and I don't have a house, so I should take this house. This is not allowed. This is haram if you force them to do that. Okay, you have to give them their rights. You have to sell this house and you give them the money, or you buy the house from them. You buy their shares from them. So you should be careful about eating the haram food or the haram money. طيب. Number 22. Times, places, and situations wherein one's supplications are most likely to be answered. I'll go quickly through this because this needs a special chapter. Number one, during the last third of the night, because the Prophet ﷺ mentioned our Lord Tabaraka wa Ta'ala descends every night to the lowest heaven when the last third of the night remains. So this is one of the very important, nice time of dua. Okay, the last third. Okay, how can I calculate this? You calculate this from the sunset until the dawn. So for example, if the sunset time, let's say, where are you? You are in UK. So what is the sunset time? It is 4. What is the dawn, not the sunrise, the dawn, the fajr. So let's say it is 6. So from 4 to 6, how many hours? 14 hours, okay, 14 hours. So you divide them into 3 parts. So the last part, okay, it will be how many hours? About 5 hours, huh? 4 and a half hours. Also, one of the main places of dua is the sujood. Okay, the closest a slave is to his Lord occurs when he is prostrating, so supplicate much. Between the adhan and the iqamah. You are in the masjid, or even if you are at home, make dua between the adhan and the iqamah. I know many people like to read Quran. No doubt this is good, but also take the chance to make dua between the adhan and the iqamah. On Friday, during an hour wherein supplications are answered. The scholars mentioned many opinions about this. Okay, many opinions. But Allahu A'lam, the most authentic opinion that this hour or this time is before the Maghrib Adhan, Jum'a day. Before the Maghrib Adhan. When a fasting person breaks his fast. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala related that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثَ لَا تُرَدْ بِدْعَوَتُهُمْ أَصَّائِمْ حَتَّى يُفْتَرْ. 3 people don't have their supplications rejected, the fasting person, until he breaks his fast. If you notice, sister, there is a difference between the title and the hadith. Because the title says, when a fasting person breaks his fast. But the hadith says, the fasting person until he breaks his fast. So what is the difference? The title tells you that at the time of breaking your fast, you make dua. But the hadith tells you, if you are fasting from al-fajr, from the dawn until the sunset, it is the time of dua. And this is authentic. Okay, because I notice this is a very common mistake. Okay, يعني I hear the muadhin, okay, I hear the muadhin, and you notice some people, they make dua. This is wrong. Why? Because the sunnah, when you hear the muadhin or when you see the sunset, immediately break your fast. Bismillah, and you drink. Or bismillah, you eat dates. This is the sunnah. But you notice some people, Allah maghfir lana warhamna wa tub alayna. Astaghfirullah al-azim. Okay. The sunnah is, you break your fast immediately, as soon as possible, when you hear the muadhin or when you see the sunset. If you like to make dua, you make dua before maghrib. You make dua before maghrib, not at the time of the adhan. Okay, at the time of the adhan, you say bismillah and you eat the date. When you hear the muadhin, you repeat with the muadhin. But to make dua during the adhan, okay, yani, Allahu a'lam. طيب, if the supplication of a person who is wronged. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said to Mu'ad, and protect yourself from the supplication of the wronged person. For indeed, there is no evil, there is no veil between him and Allah. Nothing will stop the dua of the oppressed and the wronged person. Be careful. Don't wrong anyone, sisters. And especially we oppress and we wrong the poor guys. Be careful. You should support them. Be with them, not against them. G, during the battle, and when the call to prayer is made, تنتالا تردان أو قلما تردان الدعاء عند النداء وعند البأس. Okay, two supplications are not rejected or are rarely rejected. Supplication at the time of the call to prayer and when the battle becomes intense. When the fighting armies clash and fight intensely. Okay, H, during times of affliction. And they mention da'wa dinnun. Who is dinnun? Okay, he is Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. And noon here means the whale. Noon, yes, it is one of the letters. Noon wal qalam wa ma yasturun ma anta bi ni'mati rabbika bi majnun. Okay, and one of the meanings of the letter noon is the whale, al-hoot. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is the invocation of the noon, Yunus, means Yunus, alayhi salatu wa sallam, the Prophet Yunus. What is in English, Yunus?
Jonah?
John?
I think John.
Dawood, Yahya, John.
Would you say Yunus?
Yunus. Okay. No problem. Yunus. طيب, I think you know Yunus. طيب, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is the invocation.
Jonah,
huh? Not John. John Yahya, صح? Jonah. Okay. طيب, جزاك الله خير. This is the invocation of the noon, which he supplicated with when he was inside the belly of the whale. None has the right to be worshipped but you, O Allah, how perfect you are. Verily, I was from the wrongdoers. No Muslim man supplicates with it concerning anything except that Allah answers his supplication for him. فَنَادَ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَّا إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. This is the dua of Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Also, when it is raining, also this is one of the places of the dua that will be answered, inshallah. 23 situations wherein one can reasonably hope for his supplications to be answered. يعني almost the same thing. Okay. الدُّعاء عَشِيَّةَ عَرَفَةَ. الدُّعاء عَشِيَّةَ عَرَفَةَ. The night of Arafah for those that are there at the mawqif. This is wallahi a problem, sisters. Okay, because in the Arabic language, عَشِيَّةَ عَرَفَةَ. What is العَشِيَّةَ? It is different than العشاء, because this is a wrong translation. May Allah forgive them. Maybe someone can send them Jazakumullah khair, Dar al-Salam. No doubt they did a great job. Okay, but as a human being, they do mistakes. Okay, maybe some of them can send them an email. طيب, inshallah, also we have Dar al-Salam here in Kuwait. Inshallah, I should tell them that this is a clear mistake. Because al-ashi different than al-isha. Al-isha, it is the time of al-isha salah. Or it can mean al-maghrib and isha time. But al-ashi, it is the time after dhuhr. It can include dhuhr and asr. Okay, so please, this is a clear mistake. He said the night of Arafah. It is not the night of Arafah. No, it is the time after dhuhr. I mean from dhuhr to al-maghrib. From dhuhr to al-maghrib. Because when the Prophet ﷺ went to Hajj, when he did the dua in Arafah, he did that after he joined dhuhr and asr. So after he finished asr until maghrib. And after maghrib, he went to Muzdalifah. He was not in Arafah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So please, sisters, you should correct this mistake. This is a clear mistake. That he said the night of Arafah. No, it is not the night of Arafah. It is not the night. In Arabic, he said, الدعاء عشية عرفة. عشية, العشية is different than العشاء. Okay? تمام? واضح? طيب, so this is for Arafah. And he mentioned the hadith. Also, الصفا والمروة. الصفا والمروة. When one is at Safa and Marwa, because the Prophet ﷺ was doing there. Of course, you can do this in Hajj and Umrah. When you climb the Safa, you make dua, and also when you climb Marwa, you make dua. You make dua seven times. Safa, Marwa, Safa, then Marwa, then Safa, then Marwa, then Safa, then Marwa, then Safa. So you make dua. Also, and Rami al-Jamarat. And Rami al-Jamarat. See, during Hajj, after a pilgrim builds the smaller and middle jamrah, not the bigger, not the biggest one, not the main one. Okay, Umar radiallahu ta'ala would build the closest jamrah with seven pebbles, making takbir with everyone. Tayyib, after each pebble, then he would proceed going to low ground where he would stand, face the qibla, and remain standing. For a long time, while standing, he would supplicate and raise his hands. Then he would build the middle jamra, and he will do the same. So the dua in the first one and the second, but after the third, no dua. You leave Mina. Okay, I mean you leave the jamrat al-aqaba al-kubra. You leave jamrat al-aqaba al-kubra. This is the end of the book. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. I hope that you benefit from the book. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always the success in this dunya and also paradise in akhirah. We should also remember Ulum Academy, the admin, for arranging this course. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always to understand the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also to help us to apply what we learn. Because the main thing for learning, to apply what we learn, the manners, the etiquette of dua. And also one of the important things, sisters, that teach what you learn for the others. Spread the knowledge, the good knowledge, the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Stick to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Learn the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Teach the sunnah. Okay, and make sure that the sunnah is authentic. Authentic sunnah. And this is, it is like the chain. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تسمعون ويسمع منكم ويسمع ممن سمع منكم. It is a chain. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the companions, you hear. It means you hear from me. ويسمع منكم, and it will be heard from you. ويسمع ممن سمع منكم means the tabi'een, the next generation. Okay, the second tabi'een will hear from the tabi'een. So now I learn from my sheikh or from my shuyukh, and now I am teaching you. And tomorrow you should teach your students and your children. This is like amana. If we keep this amana inside, we don't spread the amana, then we don't deserve this amana. But as Muslims, we are the nation of amr al-ma'ruf wa-nahy al-munkar. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas. Why we are the best nation? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ta'muruna bil ma'ruf تنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. We are the best nation because we take the we took the mission to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to people, to tell people to do the amr ma'roof good and to forbid from the الباطل. زاكم الله خير again sisters, and I hope that I benefit you, and this is wallahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gave me this position to teach you, and wallahi this is my pleasure. And hope to meet you again and again. And inshallah, if there is a chance, inshallah, the admin, Abu Sa'ad, will inshallah arrange another course with you. Exactly, I don't know, طيب, and when, so I don't know, maybe next week or in Ramadan, after Ramadan, Allahu A'lam. طيب, but my lectures are there, alhamdulillah. I have weekly lectures every Tuesday, every Saturday. You can find my lectures in my Instagram, my YouTube. Now we take some of the questions. And alhamdulillah, yani, wallahi, this is grace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the second time I finished the book. Alhamdulillah, I finished the book. I wrote this in April 2020, at the beginning of Corona, and this is the second time. And wallahi, yani, it is important to teach. Even if you ask me to teach you this book again from next week, I'm ready for that, and also it will be very important for us. طيب. Assalamu alaikum. Alaikum assalam. Ameen, ameen. Can we make Quranic dua in sujood? About the Quranic dua and sujood, okay, many scholars said you can make the Quranic dua and the sujood, but without the intention of Quran. Yeah, for example, now I'm in the sujood or I am the ruku'. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't read Quran in ruku' or sujood. So it means that reading Quran is not allowed. Reading Quran the ruku' or in the sujood is not allowed. But I am the ruku'. And I like the dua, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Why you are making this dua? Are you reading Quran? No. I'm not reading Quran, but I want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Then some scholars say this is okay, but no doubt. طيب, if you change, yeah, for example, you don't use رَبَّنَا, you say Allahumma. Okay, yeah, inshallah, to be safe, not to exactly take the verse from the Quran. Allahu A'lam. I mean, Zakul Khair, all the sisters who are making dua for me and for you too. When making dua in sujood, must it be in Arabic or can it be in our language? If there are not any specific Arabic dua for what we are asking, can we make dua in fard salah or only sunnah? Of course, mainly in the salah should be in Arabic. Okay, your dua, you say, Allahumma ghfirli, Allahumma arhamni. In the sujood, you say, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, in Arabic. You have to say it in Arabic. Okay, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sallu kama raytumuni salli. But for example, as you said, you want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something, you don't know how to ask it in Arabic. Okay, and you need it now. Okay, say it, inshallah, after the saying, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, say it. Some scholars said this is allowed. This is allowed. But please, sisters, try your best to learn Arabic. Okay, try your best to learn Arabic. Okay, with time, inshallah, I mean, at the beginning, it will be difficult, but inshallah, with time, it will be very easy. Not only easy, very easy, inshallah. How can one make dua to Allah against his enemy? Allahumma alayka, for example, I can say, Allahumma alayka bifulan. Or Allahumma alayka bihadhi al-dawla. Oh Allah, يعني, like suffice me from the evil of this country or from this person. Like the man, you know, the story of the boy in Surah Al-Buruj. He said, Allahumma kfini bima shi'at. Okay, oh Allah, protect me from them in any way. Can make this dua. Or you can make a dua like Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. يعني او الله اطمس على قلوبهم ودمر اموالهم او الله destroy their wealth, destroy their country. You can make dua like this if they deserve that. Is there any dua to get pregnant? يعني specifically like this. Yes, جزاك الله خير. زكريا وزكريا نادى ربه رب ربي لا تذرني فردا وأنت خير الوارثين. Oh Allah, don't leave me alone. Okay, and you are the best heirs, inheritors. سبحانه وتعالى. Okay, يعني it is not literally اللهم اجعلني حاملا. What this means to have a child, to have a child. Okay. When to make dua, fard prayer or in sunnah prayer? You can make dua in both, in the fard and in the sunnah. In the fard and in the sunnah. Are we leaving now? Okay. Can we blow surah Fatiha or any dua in water to give sir? Some scholars, yeah, many scholars say this is allowed. Many scholars say it is allowed. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Like this. Okay, then I give someone sick to drink. Many scholars say this is allowed. Why? Because this is a kind of medicine or a treatment. But some shuikh, they said, no need for that. Why? If the sick person is here, okay, put your hand and read Surah Fatiha directly. No need to put this water in between you and him. Directly you read Surah Fatiha. Is it allowed to supplicate in Sajda during the first salah, also in our mother tongue? I answered this. Can we general and ask Allah Wahab to gift us a righteous child? Yes. Yes. You can, Rabbi, habli a good child, a righteous, pious, half of the Quran, okay, a scholar. No problem. Ask him. Is it compulsory to cover head while supplications? If you mean outside the salah, no, it is not. You are assisted, you are sitting at home alone or with your family, no need to cover the head. Okay, I think we discussed this many times at the beginning, because many sisters think that I have to cover my head while reading the Quran. This is not compulsory. It's not compulsory. As I know, we don't have any hadith to tell us it is wajib to cover your head while making dua or reading Quran. But if you mean in the salah, you have to cover. If you mean in the salah, during the salah, you have to cover. Can we separately make sujood for dua after salah? This is not sunnah from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not sunnah from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I mean, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do, and he did not tell us, if you are making dua, okay, do it in sujood. Okay? He did not say that, and he did not do that. Okay? Separately. But you can do this if you are praying al-fard, if you are praying sunnah, make the dua during the sujood. طيب, I mean, teaching is very difficult as there are many obstacles. Everyone asks for ijazah. Okay, I don't mean that to teach in a college or an institute or in the masjid. You can't teach your children. You teach your sisters. You teach your parents, you teach your nephew, your niece. Okay, yani being a teacher doesn't mean that I have a certificate and I'm highly qualified to teach everyone. Okay, teach your children. Maybe you teach any, when you go to the masjid, okay, the prayer room of the sisters, Jum'ah day, you see maybe a lady, you can't tell her how to pray according to the sunnah. Okay, you can speak with her, you chat with her, you find a young girl and you teach her something. Okay, teach in any way, not necessary to be a teacher in a school. How as the salah duha is done? I have never done it. Wallahi duha salah, it is highly recommended. Duha salah, a duha salah, it is between the sunrise and dhuhr adhan, or exactly after the sunrise in about 15 minutes or 12 minutes. Yeah, for example, here in Kuwait, it is 12 minutes. As Sheikh Ma'thaymi rahimahullah mentioned, so when you see the sunrise, wait 12 minutes, then you can pray. And before the dhuhr adhan, in 5 minutes, 4 minutes, something like that. Okay, so yeah, maybe 5 hours, 6 hours. It depends what is the country and what is the season, with summer or winter. Okay, you pray 2 rak'ah, 4 rak'ah, 6 rak'ah, 10 rak'ah, 100 rak'ah. It's up to you. Should I recite anything specifically? No, nothing specific to recite. But this is highly recommended, sisters. please from, I don't, can I say not from today because maybe you miss the time. Okay, but maybe if you are in US, yes, you can pray now. I think it is Duha in US. طيب, or from tomorrow, pray Duha. At least two rak'ah. طيب, this is highly recommended. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to pray Duha four rak'ah and more. As Aisha said in Hadith in Sahih Muslim. What are the main questions we should ask a potential spouse, husband? Jazakallah khairan. يعني, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا أتاكم ترضون دينه وخلقه. So if a man came to your father, he wants to marry you. Okay, so your father should check with him, not you. يعني, please sisters. يعني, many times I noticed that sisters chat with the man. Okay, and they like to meet him. Okay, phone call, messaging, meeting. Okay, please don't do that. Let your father to meet him or your brother, your uncle. To meet him, okay? You are a revert, let Imam Masjid or the Islamic Center, if there is Islamic Center, okay? Because this is risky that you meet the man many times, you chat with him. Okay, this is not good. It's not good, okay? If your father likes to ask, okay, let him make sure about his salah. And mainly you ask about him. You don't ask him directly. Yes, you can ask him, no doubt. You ask him, okay, direct questions, okay? But mainly you should ask about him. Go to his friends and ask his friends. Go to his masjid. Ask Imam Masjid, okay, do you see this man regularly in the masjid or not? Okay, ask his friends, okay, how is this man? Is he generous or stingy? Is this man brave or coward? Okay, his akhlaq, he's shouting or he's using bad words, nice word. What do you know about his relationship with his parents? This is very important, okay? He should be very nice with his parents, okay? And I have a lecture. You can find my lecture, how to choose your spouse. What are, yes. Is it allowed to read Quran on one's phone whilst laying down? Or is this district? No, it's okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ تَكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ. Okay, so this is allowed. This is allowed. I tell my teachers to make dua for me or my parents or my children. Is it allowed? Is it allowed? This is allowed if you think that your teachers are good people. Okay, pious, righteous, no doubt, inshallah. Okay, is it allowed? Is it allowed? But some scholars don't recommend this, like Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, doesn't recommend this. Okay, you like to make dua, you make dua for yourself. And yes, we mentioned something last week about this, but it is allowed. Can we make dua for all the prayers while praying? You can make dua during Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. You make dua. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Can we pray nafil or recite Quran for the deceased ones? As a sunnah, we don't have any sunnah from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to recite Quran for my father who passed away, rahimahullah. To recite Quran for him, we don't have anything from the Sunnah to support that the Prophet did that or he told us to do that. Okay, we don't have any Sunnah. Pray, if you mean to pray as-salah, okay, we should not do that. Yes. As Ibn Abbas said, لا يصلي أحد عن أحد ولا يصوم أحد عن أحد. You should not pray for anyone. But if you mean dua, yes, this is Sunnah. You make dua for the deceased one. While traveling, do we have, okay. To be frank, yes, many scholars, maybe major scholars say, yes, it is allowed. You recite Quran, then you send the reward for your parents. Okay, but as the proof from the Sunnah, we don't have a specific proof from the Sunnah about that. While traveling, do we have to raise hands for supplications? You don't have, but this is an etiquette. It is recommended, it is recommended. Any particular dua of the oppressed persons, you can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. فَدَعَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصِرْ. Oh Allah, I am overcome, so help me. This is the dua of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. You can use the dua from the Quran. How can we enjoin good and forbid evil when people don't like to discuss their flaws? Do your best. I see something wrong. Okay, I try to correct this in a wise way. That's it. You need to be wise, polite, and with knowledge, of course. Zakallah khair. Ameen. Zakallah khair, all sisters who are making dua for me. Barakallah feekum. Respect Sheikh, you say that we can say that, Ya Rabb, I did this good deed and that good deed. Doesn't it count as praising oneself? No. I'm not praising myself. This is between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is between me and Allah. And we mentioned the proof for that last week. The dua, when the three people entered the cave and the stone covered the door of this cave. So everyone asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with one of his deeds. No, I'm not praising myself. I'm mentioning this for people. But I'm talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we repeat the small dua and sujood? You can repeat. In the sujood, you say, Allahumma ghfirli, Allahumma ghfirli, Allahumma ghfirli. As we mentioned last week, it is also one of the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to repeat the dua three times. Okay, repeat the dua three times. While traveling by car as a passenger, should we stop the car to do salah? If you mean the fard salah, yes, you have to stop. The fard salah, you have to stop. But for the nafil, you can pray in your car. You can pray in your car. Can we pray salah at duha before dhuhr adhan? Yes, before dhuhr adhan, but 10 minutes, for example, 20 minutes, not immediately after the dhuhr. Because immediately after dhuhr, this is forbidden time. Forbidden time. Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. What if you do ya azizu, ya ghaffar, after doing Allahumma innaka afoon, tuhibbul af, fa'fu anna. Is it okay? Yani, as a dua, okay. Yani, it is a dua, no doubt. You are using one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the name al-aziz doesn't go with the maghfira, yani, generally. With the maghfira used, Ya Ghafoor, Ya Ghaffar. Not Ya Aziz, Ya Ghaffar. Use Ya Ghafoor, Ya Ghaffar. Or Ya Afu, Ya Ghaffar. Like that. How to make dua after tashahud? Can you explain the way for that? In the tashahud, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama salaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, naka hamidun majid wa barak ala Muhammad. You say this. Then after that, you say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabi jahannam, min adhabi al-qabr, min fitnat al-mahya wal-mat, wa min sharri fitnat al-masih al-dajjal. Allahumma ghfirni, Allahumma inni akafun, tuhibbu al-afu, fa'afu anni, Allahumma hasibni hisaban yasir. You make dua like that. And some of the dua from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For example, ya Allahumma hasibni hisaban yasira. While traveling by car, yes, so do you expect our usual test for the last, you checked with the admin, I don't know anything about the test, sorry. Can we repeat, okay, how to make dua after, I repeated the questions. Can we make dua in our own language to grant, I mentioned this. Can we read Quran without ablution and without covering the head? Yes, but without touching. If you're driving, does this apply to men or sisters too? To stop your car and pray outside? I mentioned for the fard, you have to stop your car and you pray outside. You need to stand up, you face the Qibla, you pray perfectly. But for the nafil, okay, you pray in your car, but you have to make the ablution. Of course. Is it wrong to wipe our face after holding out our hands during the dua? This is not sunnah. There is a hadith, but it is not authentic hadith. That after I make dua, and at the end of your dua, this is not sunnah. This is not sunnah. The hadith is not authentic. How to deal with non-Muslim parents who doesn't want you to practice religion of Islam and are very harsh to you. Make dua for them. And also, if they try to stop you doing the wajib, don't obey them. If they are pushing you to do the haram, don't obey them. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear in the Quran, وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِي عِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطِحُمَا. If they try their best to make you shirk, to make you mushrik, don't obey them. Then he said, وَصَحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُفَةً. Be kind with them. But don't obey them in doing the haram, in doing the wrong. Okay, I understand this is not easy. especially if you are young, okay? Maybe your parents are 50 years old, okay? And you are a young girl. You are maybe 14 years old. You are 16 years old. Still, you are in the school, okay? No doubt, this is very difficult, very difficult. But try to be wise and to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Then if you can please them without doing haram, please your parents, no problem. This is ajr, bidn Allah. Does a woman have to get out of the car to pray for if she is alone and it may not be safe? Do you have to get out of the car if you are traveling? What do you mean if it is not safe? Okay, first of all, if she will miss the time, okay, we'll tell the sister, pray, then drive your car. For example, you are going from one place to another place. Okay, so pray, okay, then go. But also there is another issue. You mentioned that you are traveling alone. This is forbidden for the woman to travel alone. So do you mean that driving a car from one place to another place, it is only 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or 20 minutes, or 30 minutes, okay, from your work to your home? Okay, inshallah, you can reach and you pray on time. Or if you don't think you will not reach within the time, then wait, okay, a few minutes, pray on time, then you go to that place. But if you mean traveling, okay, 3 hours, 4 hours from one city to another city, you should not travel alone. You should not travel alone. Okay, but generally, if you are in a situation, okay, you feel it is very difficult, it is dangerous, no doubt. إِذَا ضَاقَ الْأَمْرُ اتَّسَعْ When you, the scholars say, if it is very narrow, Allah will make it wide. Allah will make it loose. So, I cannot tell you, pray in the car. It depends on your situation. Which name of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, should we use to make our dua or wish to be accepted? For example, if you are in a very difficult situation, you say, أَمَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى. Okay. يَا مُجِيبُ الدَّعْوَاتِ, for example. يَا مَنْ قَالَ وَقَوْلُ الْحَقِّ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Oh Allah, you said that. Invoke me, I answer you. You can't say something like that. If you ask your parents for what they want, when they are gone and they tell you and they want you to do whatever they want you to do for them before they die, to get the reward before they die, can you do that if you have the means? Sorry, I did not get the point. Can we make our dua after tashahud in our language? The same answer like the sujood. You can, inshallah, if you don't know specifically how to use the Arabic words. Can a woman pray in public if she's with a hijab? Okay, she can pray like the haram. Okay, like the women, when they go to Mecca and Medina, they are praying in the public. Okay, but I feel, wallah, very sorry. There is a common mistake, sisters. There is a very common mistake, which is that many sisters, when they pray without a full hijab. Why? Because already they are without a proper hijab. I mean, covering the head is not a hijab by itself. Because for many sisters, what is the definition of hijab? Is to cover my hair. Okay, but you are with a trouser. This is not a hijab. This is not a proper hijab. Okay, so they pray with their trousers. This is wrong. This is wrong. You should be with abaya. Okay, you should be with something loose. So you are at home or in the public, you should not pray with your trouser. Okay, like the jeans and these things. Okay, I like that the sisters to take this issue seriously. I mean, the issue of hijab, this is very important, sister. Please try your best to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't please yourself if it is haram. Allah musta'an. Sunnah way to raise hands while making dua. Yes, this is sunnah. We discussed this. Generally, it is sunnah, but not always, because in the Jum'ah khutbah, it is not sunnah to raise the hand. Okay, we mentioned this. Zakumullah khair, sister. I think we took more than 1 hour. Mashallah, we took 1 hour and 20 minutes. You can send your question in the group, Telegram group, or to my direct message and the Telegram, or those who have my WhatsApp. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Wallahi, I'm very happy to be with you. We started from, I think, June, yani maybe 7 or 8 months. This is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be with you. And again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us in Al-Firdaws Al-A'la. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.